Kia ora. Check out this gorgeous bloom cut file by Confessions of a Paper Addict. Virginia's really blown it out of the water with this one. I have gone ahead and backed it with a really colourful paper, so instead of doing lots of individual pieces behind all of the parts, A, I was possibly being a bit lazy, but B, I really liked the look of this brightness when I sort of held the cut file over the top of it, so I just went with that. So I have stuck that down and then fussy cut around that. What I'm going to do now is use this paper, which I believe was from Happiest Place, from Close to My Heart. It was a collection, I think, that came out last year. And I'm using the pattern paper as my background. And I'm just going through and using some of these Dina Wakely gloss acrylic sprays. And I've chosen some really bright colours that I felt would complement the cut file that I've got there to the left. So I've gone for an orangey colour, a blue, and a limey colour, and then just using the heat gun there just to dry that off so that I can carry on with the layout and make a move quickly. So I've backed this cut file, and I do decide to place it reasonably centrally, but I feel like it needs something down the bottom. So I found this other paper, I think this was from the same collection, and I decided to sort of trim off some of these cool swirly patterns. It looks like scribbles on this pretty blue colour. And I pop that down there, but it kind of just looks a little bit plain. So I decide to pull out another strip of that and then get fussy cutting. So I, and the zip strip or the manufacturer strip. So I'm just going to fussy cut around each of these sort of little doodle swirls and use that on my page as well. So here we go. They're all cut out. They're ready to go. And I am going to sort of stick them to the back of the strip. So I'm just putting the adhesive there, and then I'm going to attach them there. So I'm working backwards at the moment, and I'm going to attach that along the top, and then that becomes sort of a cool swirly pattern leading into the layout. And I'm going to use that manufacturer's strip up there with the black and white dots between the two layers, so you sort of can't see the seal or the difference between them because you've made that really bold and obvious with the dotty manufacturer strip. So anyway, so I pop that down there and really like how that comes out in the end. So I am going to cover some of that up with my photos, but that's just giving a really cool base, just a bit of difference than the straight patterned paper that was there to start with. So you can see how that's sitting there, and I'm going to kind of have the cut file coming out of it. So just rearranging that till it sits the way I like it, and I do decide to have it fairly central. I love that this isn't a symmetrical cut file, so all of these flowers and things, it's got different angles and different points, so it looked really cool being centered on the page. So I'm going to mat each of my photos with some white daisy cardstock. Now these photos are ones of sort of found objects. So in New Zealand in August we had a lockdown, so most of the country was in a lockdown for a week or two, and then it was 2 weeks, and then we moved into a level three, and then we moved into level two, which is still quite a few restrictions, limited numbers and stuff. But anyway, part of being in a lockdown is that we can go walking in our local area, and I have this amazing walking track down near the river. And my daughter and I, my older daughter, so she's 18, no, not 18, that's my other daughter, she is 21, and we went for a walk down by the river, and I spied these beautifully painted rocks. They were just a really nice surprise, and just added a bit of a smile to my face as I was wandering along this track. And I noticed, I think they were done by one of the local primary schools, so hopefully, or I wonder if that was a bit of a plan by one of their teachers for some distance learning kind of stuff, to spread a little bit of joy and happiness, and they certainly did. So it was really cool to see them. So of course, being me, I had to take some photos, and when looking at this cut file and thinking about the bright colours, it just I just thought happiness, and it was kind of like, let's pull all this happy stuff together. And so they talk about scrapbooking being a bit like therapy, and I think In many ways for me it is, it can be sort of that uplifting time, or it can also be a time of reflection and thinking and documenting some of the feelings that sometimes it's a bit hard to put into words, but when you can put it into an art form, it can be just quite relaxing and freeing. So backing the paper, the photos that I've matted with a few different colors that you can see me doing there, and I do try to keep the bottom row, the three that I'm going to put down the bottom, the same, but that one that's sort of a sunny scene, less animal related, I'm going to pop that up the top and tuck that in behind this really cool cut file. So I've kind of got those photos matted and ready to go, and I am sticking them down onto the different layers, and I'm going to use some foam tape for my photo up the top. And I do wonder about lifting it up higher, but I decide that I'm going to tuck that under. So I have used a foam tape to attach the bloom cut file, but the photo did just needed that little bit of lift, and it tucked in beautifully up the top there. This is a really busy page, but I feel that the photos still stand out, because in a way it's just the rock with a simple kind of background, and the way I've positioned them down the bottom sort of draws your eye into them, and then you're like, oh, what's happening up the top there? So in a way there's a triangle, so you've got a row of three down the bottom pointing up to that one up the top, plus you've got the really cool cut file that just sort of makes you want to look around the page a bit more. You can't see it very well on the video, but the splatters in the background add a really nice subtle effect in there, and I will enhance those shortly when I put some other acrylic dots. Now, to attach these acrylic letters, I put them through a Xyron. So this is one of the Xyron minis, or the Xyron portables, and I threaded them through. They were kind of a bit thicker than perhaps what you would normally put through something like that, but it worked really well. I was a bit reluctant to put adhesive all over them because they're quite a fine tip, and I do have to clean out my my liquid glass. The nozzle's got a bit thick, or got a bit blocked up. I must have left it on too long. So I was trying to think outside the square, and I spied that at my desk, and I thought, yep, I'll give that a go. And I'm really impressed with how well they've actually stuck down with it. So even now, I can touch those letters and there's absolutely no lift or movement. So I would recommend that again for attaching acrylic shapes. Yeah, it was pretty good. So you can see me here just with the scissors clearing out some of the glue tape that was left between those, and I managed to successfully remove all of that. So really happy with how this is looking, and I do pull out these acrylic flowers, but I decide I'm not going to use them because this cut file is already there, the floral's there, it looks pleasing to the eye, and it's sort of got that bright happy energy that the rocks had for me when I found them. So I'm just going to use one of the circles on this the patterned paper background as my sort of journaling block, and it works quite nicely with the white jelly pen. So now I'm just using some stickles. So I'm using the diamond stickles by Ranger, and I'm putting them in the center of the two flowers that have centers. And as this dries, it comes out really crystalline. It's got this nice rough, almost feels like sand when you rub your finger over it. And it just has this a nice shimmer and shine, and another added interest point to this gorgeous cut file. So I've just added the date around the circle, just saying August 2021, because this was at the start of the lockdown. As we moved into September was when we moved into level 3. So I'm using some acrylic dots. I think these are from the Daisy Meadows collection that was out last year. Love acrylic dots. I think I could use them just about on every page, and I possibly just about have recently. But yeah, they just add a nice sweet dimension, a softness, without changing the theme or the complete feel of the page. And as I said earlier, the gloss sprays that were in there really get lifted, or they draw your eye, and you're like, oh, there's something else behind there with those acrylic dots. So here's some close-up images of this layout. Great Cutfile, cool colours that I enjoyed using. So these are various close to my heart papers. And yeah, I hope you've enjoyed watching this and perhaps got something out of this. I wonder if you've found any painted rocks on your journeys around and walks and things, and if they brought a smile to your face like these ones did for me. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this, please subscribe and head over to Etsy to have a look at this Cutfile by Confessions of a Paper Addict. Thanks for watching.